This is the summary on the topic ratios. The first point is a ratio is a comparison of two sizes of two or more quantities of the same kind by division. And the second point is we write this as A is to B, or we can also write it in different forms. That is, ratio of A to B can also be written as A by B, okay, or it can also be mentioned in the ratio form, that is A is to B. And the third point is here A and B are the terms of the ratio, where A is the antecedent part and B is the consequent part. First term is called as antecedent and the second term as consequent. Fourth point is compound ratio. The compound ratio of two given ratio can be calculated as, now if the ratios are A is to B and C is to D, the compound ratio will be AC is to BD, okay. And the fifth point is duplicate ratio. Duplicate ratio of A is to B is A squared is to B squared. So, we will be writing in the power of 2. And the sixth point is triplicate ratio of A is to B. It is making the power to 3. So, A cube is to B cube is the triplicate ratio of A is to B. And the seventh point is inverse ratio. Inverse ratio in the sense A by B is written as B by A. That is, A is to B is written as B is to A. And the eighth point is the continued ratio of ABC. If there are three terms in a continued ratio, we will be writing in the form A is to B is to C. This is about the summary of ratio. Then we will be seeing about the summary of proportions. Summary of proportions. First point is equality of two ratios is called as proportion. It is represented in the form, if the ratios A is to B and C is to D are in proportion, we will write that as A is to B is equal to C is to D, or A is to B is proportional to C is to D. Here we have to remember the cross product rule, that is product of means is equal to product of extreme. And the next point is continuous proportion, in the sense there will be only three terms, that is A, B and C. But you will be writing that in the proportional form, that is A is to B will be equal to B is to C. Here also the product of extremes will be equal to product of means. In the sense, if we write it, we will get B squared is equal to AC. Here the mean proportional value will be B, okay. So if we want to find the value for B, it is equal to root of AC. This is about the summary of proportions. The next one is going to be summary of indices. In the summary of indices, here there are the basic laws that we use in the indices problem. The first one is A power m into A power n will be equal to A power m plus n. Okay, here the base is common and we will be adding up the power values. So, m plus n is the power of A. Okay, second point is that if that is in the division form, that is A power m by A power n will be written as A power m minus n. Okay, here the base is same, but the it is mentioned in the division form. So, we are using the minus symbol. And the third point is A power m power n is equal to A power m n. Okay, if the power is raised to another power, we will be multiplying the powers and the base will be same only. So, A power m n is the answer. And the fourth point is A B power n. Okay, if the power is in the for two terms, we will be taking the power within brackets. So, we will be getting A power n into B power n. This is the things that important things that we have to remember while solving the indices problem. And the next one is about summary of logarithms. Summary of logarithm. First point is to find power of a term. We are using the concept of logarithm to find the power of a term. If we have to find the value from the logarithmic value, we will be using the anti-logarithm concept. Okay. Now, the next point is for A power x is equal to n, log n to the base a is equal to x. So, while finding the power value, we'll be using the concept, and this is a general form in which we'll be using the logarithmic value. Okay. The next one is log m n to the base a is equal to log m to the base a plus log n to the base a. If the logarithmic value is given in the multiplication form, we'll be splitting it into the additional form. And the next one is log m by n to the base a is equal to log m to the base a minus log n to the base a. Here similarly, there for multiplication we used addition concept, here for division we'll be using subtraction. And the next one, if there are powers in the logarithmic value, we'll be taking in front and we'll be using that as a multiplication value. So log m power n to the base a is written as n into log m to the base a. And the last point is log m to the base b will be written as log m to the base a by log b to the base a. Okay, here we are changing the base to be a common value. So, for this we will be using this formula. This is the chapter end.